Hi there, I'm Emma Peel from PBS, and today I'm going to visit one of our most psychedelic and way out announcers, Mr. Paul Kidney, who hosts Ear of the Behera. To find out what lies in the depths of his record collection, we're going to have a cup of tea, teddy bear biscuit, and we're going to dig on Paul Kidney. Let's go!
Emma Peel.
Hey Paul, how are you?
I'm great.
Here's a present.
Yay! I love Vickies.
I like it a lot. Now, of course, we're here to talk about your record collection and just to get inside the mind of Paul Kidney.
So it's a bit hard.
Yeah, well, I know. We might have to dedicate some time to it. But I wonder if you could tell us in 10 words or less, or describe in 10 words or less what your musical style is.
Psychedelia, but that sort of expands to the outer reaches of psychedelia. Like,
really?
I feel that noise music is the outer edges of psychedelia.
Right, so noise music's where you're at.
That's where I'm at.
Fair enough. Could you tell us about the first album that you ever bought?
Hang on, I'll go get it. The very first album I bought was a Beatles album.
I see.
It's called The Beatles Rock and Roll Music. And it's not that good really, but...
No, it's not their finest work.
I bought it after my grandmother gave me the cassette of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, which is really good. Yeah. Well, listening to it later, I think, no, it's dated, but it's still got marvellous songs on it.
That's a good entry point when you're
it
a
is
kid,
a
perhaps.
Fantastic entry point.
Now, moving on, what's the last record or the most recent record you've purchased?
It's not one record, it's about 15 or something. I've got a whole bunch of electronic things from the people in America called Memoroglia Music. They do a electronic series of stuff, 1952 to 1984.
Ah, cool.
It's really oddity, rare, weird stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Here's a whole bunch. Electron Music Studion from Sweden and Jean Boyu and Klaus Roeder.
So European stuff.
Yeah, well, not all. There's this American dude there, Jack Tamul.
Cool.
All sorts of places, even Australia and New Zealand.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, everywhere. And there's also a couple of other Dwight Frizzell albums that I have here.
Interesting.
Mm. That's the CDs.
Okay.
Then I've got this great Earthling Society album. Really good modern psychedelia from England.
Cool.
And Cage Berrio Druckmann, you know, early avant classical stuff.
French.
Pierre Henry, two albums there. And Music Experimental 2 and Bernard Parmigiani and Amancio de Silva, Cosmic Eye. And James Brown.
Jeez,
can you dig it?
You're buying a lot of records then.
Yeah.
I guess that's what you have to do when you're presenting a show that goes for, what is it, four hours?
4 hours, but it's only once a fortnight, so it's the same as a two-hour show once a week.
I guess that's true. Now, can you tell me about an album that you bought that unexpectedly blew your mind and tell me why?
It would have to be Orgasm by Cro-Magnon. It's an American freak-out album, and Americans don't freak out a great deal.
Really?
Yes, but this is great.
Cool.
You know, it's up there with something like Armand Duhl or early Can albums or something.
Oh,
really,
love a bit of early
really
Can.
Really nice.
Very good. All right. If your house was burning down, and you could only take one record, what would it be and why?
I reckon it would have to be The Misunderstood Before the Dream Faded. It's only one side that I really want, and it's the first side. Oh, sorry. She's so good. She's such a DJ. It's, yeah, this album, Before the Dream Faded, fantastic songs on side one. Side two, well, earlier and not so good, but whatever.
Really?
Yeah.
But you still take that one?
That's the one. That's the album I think is my finest piece.
Okay.
I think.
Now, most record collectors and DJs have records that are a guilty pleasure that they don't want anyone else to know about somewhere in the depths of their collection. I wondered whether you've got any Kylie Minogue somewhere in your back cupboard.
I don't have any Kylie, but I do have Cat Stevens.
Oh.
It's got
I hate
Moon
Cat
Shadow
Stevens.
On it. Who does? No one likes him, but yeah, I've got it.
Good on you. Maybe next time Hard Rubbish comes around, put it out.
No, I've got some really hard rubbish ones there, but I'm not telling you about them.
Okay. And finally, what is a song that you put on and dance around to in your lounge room when no one else is here?
I dance around in front of anyone, anytime,
I
to
know.
Anything. And whether it's me at a noise gig or a something, anything. But the thing I really like dancing to is the Spencer Davis Group's I'm a Man.
Great song. Great choice.
Thanks.
Shall we hit the floor?
Okay.
Let's go.